Welcome to Kiel, the capital of the federal state Schleswig-Holstein. We're at the shores of the Baltic Sea in one of the most important maritime centers in Germany. As many other cities, Kiel had to adapt to manage the crisis posed by this pandemic. It turns out that the digital transformation strategy has helped Kiel to be more resilient in this pandemic. Today, we will find out stories of how the innovation ecosystem has adapted its way of functioning to hybrid events. We'll get to know someone from the digitalization team within the municipal services, and we'll find out how the social media strategy has worked well in communicating this crisis.
The Vatican Festival is a kind of shop window for innovative projects from Northern Europe, and we try to showcase them and also empower others to do the same. One of our mottos is calm down is just uncertainty, and it tells us that it's completely normal to have uncertainty, especially in these even more uncertain times in terms of COVID-19. Vatican Festival is all about startups and innovative approaches, so we'll need to be innovative as well to kind of show the others and also to try to inspire each other. This year we had for 3 weeks long a live stream. This was like the core part of the festival. We had really a much more broader audience. We had like maybe 40 countries tuning in into our program. This is definitely the power of digitalization. The really great thing about our ecosystem is here that there's a lot of trust. So basically, we are able to be here in this hall because of the permission of Kiel. We are kind of temporary user and they trust us with the stuff that we're doing. We don't need to ask for every step for permission. The other thing is we are also like publicly funded from the state of Schleswig-Holstein and also their trust us. We just say, okay, that's the way we want to go. And this gives us a lot of freedom to experiment. That's why we could react to different circumstances.
I told us the chance for you to get with less waiting time, more opportunities. So if you want to go to a restaurant spontaneous, you have the chance to show how many people are waiting in front of you and how long you have to wait. In March, all the gastronomy were closed and we need to think about our business model, and we didn't know how long the lockdown will go on. So we had the idea to change it to doctor offices and hospitals. The Vatican Festival this year was hybrid, so we had the chance to test our digital waiting list. So the people were checked in on the waiting list and get a message when they can go safely. So we have the opportunity to challenge our business model that we changed because of the pandemic, and had the opportunity to talk to the mayor of Kiel for maybe other business ideas in public services.
Wir arbeiten alle zusammen in der Stabsstelle Digitalisierung. Die gibt es jetzt so circa anderthalb, zwei Jahre. Sie fingen damals an mit der Einstellung des Chief Digital Officer, unserem CDO sozusagen. Und mittlerweile sind wir aber ein Team von 10 MitarbeiterInnen. Im März haben wir als erstes eben versucht, eine Erste-Hilfe-Kit auf die Beine zu stellen, welches Videoconferencing beinhaltet, welches ein digitales Flipchart beinhaltet hat und welches die Möglichkeit beinhaltet, digital an Dokumenten gemeinsam arbeiten zu können, sodass die Leute, die auf einmal ins Homeoffice kamen, zusammenarbeiten konnten. In der Stadtverwaltung ist ja nicht so, dass Homeoffice eigentlich zur Tagesordnung gehörte. Wenn das mal jemand gemacht hat, dann musste man einen Telearbeitsantrag stellen. Dieser Antrag hat mehrere Monate gedauert und dann hat man einen vollständigen Arbeitsplatz zu Hause eingerichtet gekriegt. Wir haben eigentlich als erstes damit angefangen, uns auf die Suche zu begeben, ein Videokonferenzsystem einzuführen. Damit können die Menschen ja noch gar nicht damit um. Also was muss ich alles bedenken, wenn ich in ein Webmeeting gehe? Wie teile ich meinen Bildschirm? Wie verhalte ich mich? Diese ganzen kulturellen Mechanismen, die haben wir halt aufgeschrieben, haben dafür kleine Anleitungen gemacht, und im Hintergrund bauen wir gerade einen komplett Open Source digitalen Arbeitsplatz auf. So hat zum Beispiel das Jugendamt das Videotool dann auch genutzt, um mit den Klienten in Kontakt zu treten. Weil aufgrund der Kontaktbeschränkungen war es eben nicht möglich, einfach die Beratung durchzuführen. Und da hat das Videotool direkt weitergeholfen. Wir haben einen Raum eingerichtet, der soll auch als Begegnungsstätte fungieren. Dort haben wir ja ganz verschiedene Möbel reingebaut, die man auch modular zusammenstellen kann, sodass wir auch andere Mitarbeiter einladen können, um bei uns und zusammen mit uns Workshops zu veranstalten, um auch zu sehen, wie wie kann agiles Arbeiten auch zusammen mit anderen Abteilungen funktionieren. Das ist zum Beispiel ein Learning, also machen und es funktioniert eigentlich auch. Ein zweites Learning wäre, überlegt euch, mit wem könnt ihr draußen zusammenarbeiten und probiert Lösungen aus. Und wenn die Lösungen gut sind, dann übertragt sie und dann baut sie aber sauber nach in der Verwaltung.
The pandemic forces us to communicate in a faster way and in a direct, a more direct way with the people from Kiel. I try to answer every question. It's like we have 300 up to 1,000 comments each day. So it's a lot of work, but we get a lot of positive feedback back because our numbers of followers rised immediately since the first lockdown. The beginning we have like 13,000 followers on Instagram, now we have 23,000. With the rising numbers of followers, we also had a rising number of trolls and persons who are interested in conspiracy theories. I started to answer and discuss with them because I think we have to explain it to them why the conspiracy theories are wrong. But you have to know when to stop. You have to tell them, okay, please look here and otherwise please leave our channel. It's not always easy, but we have a great community which handle a lot of this posts itself. I think there are some cities where social media is just like an add-on for their normal work. But you can't do it as an add-on. It's a really important part of the communication for the city.
This is how the city of Kiel has managed to cope with the challenges posed by this pandemic. We've seen stories from the innovation ecosystem. We got to know the digital transformation team of the municipality of Kiel, and we understood how important a good crisis communication through social media might be. If you want to know more about good practices from all over the world, please visit our YouTube channel or come to one of our virtual Connective Cities events. Stay safe and goodbye. We'll be right back.